everyone, this is Lilibeth Serrano with the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. Today I'm at NC State College of Veterinary Medicine, and I'm going to be visiting for the first time the Aquatics Epidemiology Conservation Lab. I'm going to speak with Chris Eade, who's the coordinator, and he's going to tell us about the work he's doing with the yellow lands.
Hey,
hi, Chris.
This is the Mussel Barn at the NC State College of Veterinary Medicine.
Okay.
So would you like the tour now?
Yep, show me around.
So this barn is entirely dedicated to the propagation of freshwater mussels and research on their life history and aquaculture. This half of the lab is all dedicated to holding fish. Mm-hmm. You're familiar with their life cycle. They require the use of a host fish in order to complete their transformation from a larvae or larva to a juvenile. We bring in their host fish from the wild. Different species of mussel require different species of fish to use as a host. So this is the host fish we would use for the yellow lance or the tar river spiny mussel. So we will hold them typically in this system here when they first come in the lab, and we'll quarantine them to make sure they're not holding any diseases or bringing any diseases into the lab. Larvae go in here with a small volume of water and the appropriate number of fish. We aerate it, and larvae will be in suspension inside this jar. And as the fish and the larvae are in there together, the larvae will attach either to the fins of the fish or the gills of the fish. They come out with shells, but they come out open when they come out of the female. When they come in contact with the fish, the shells will clamp shut on the gills or the fins of the fish. These are tanks that we use when we're actually infest fish with the larvae of the mussel. We get a lot of condensation because I'm chilling the tanks. So these are white shiners. By now they're not in use, but they will be later in the year, probably in May, just when we'll start using those for yellow ants. About every day or two is just clean these screens off and rinse the juveniles down, because they'll get biofilm that clogs the screen or kind of fouls the juveniles a little bit. Is that showing up?
Huh. It looks so like sand.
Yeah. So they are about 0.2 millimeters in size individually when they first drop off the fish. These are three yellow lance that we reared in ponds in 2017. They're just right now in temporary holding here in the lab, but they'll probably go back out to a pond where we're doing the secondary grow out in a month. So when the water warms up out in the ponds, they'll go back out there and they will grow a lot faster in a pond with a natural water source, a richer diet, than they will here. So these are yellow lances propagated in 2016, and they've been reared in the laboratory here. You can see that they're smaller than the ones that we had reared in the pond.
The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service is working with state resource agencies and others to recover the yellow lands and other threatened and endangered mussels that live in the same habitat and share similar needs to thrive in the wild. We're working with Wake County, the North Carolina Wildlife Resources Commission, and the North Carolina State University to renovate the research area of the A.E. Finley Center, the Yates Mill Historic County Park. Located just 5 miles south of downtown Raleigh, the park is managed as a native wildlife refuge and includes a 20-acre pond. The Yates Mill Pond would be a reliable source of untreated, free-flowing water rich in algae and nutrients for young mussels to thrive. The new facility would be known as the Yates Mill Aquatic Conservation Center. Once renovated, the center would provide opportunities for teaching, research, and outreach. Startup funds for mussel propagation and research are already in place, thanks to the National Fish and Wildlife Foundation. Additional funds for design, construction, and operation would be provided by the North Carolina Department of Transportation. Building and operating the Yates Mill Aquatic Conservation Center would benefit the Yellowlands and other federally listed and at-risk animals, including the endangered dwarf wedge mussel, the Tar River spiny mussel, and the magnificent ram's horn snail, which is currently under review and is a candidate for federal protection.